Hey guys, we are back outside again today because today we're experimenting with a relatively dangerous substance. Today we're playing with propane. Now in our standard atmosphere, propane is typically a gas, but if you compress it into a bottle like this, it actually liquefies under its own vapor pressure. If you shake one of these bottles and listen carefully, you can actually hear liquid propane sloshing around inside. The purpose of today's experiment is to see if we can get that liquid propane out. Now, if you remember back to a previous experiment, we took a carbon dioxide fire extinguisher and sprayed it into a pillowcase to create homemade dry ice. And the process for doing that is very similar to how we're gonna extract our liquid propane here today. Now, I wanna give a shout out to my friend Kevin. He's the backyard scientist, and before he started playing with liquid nitrogen, he used liquid propane. And the way he would do that was by modifying the torch for the propane tank itself and sticking it upside down into glass. So we're gonna make that modification here today, and I'm gonna show you step by step how it works. Because of the pressure the propane is putting on the inside of the tank, it wants to escape. And so by opening the valve counterclockwise, more propane can shoot out, and by turning it clockwise, it restricts the flow and limits the flame, eventually shutting it off. Now this is kind of interesting. If you look down in the tip of the nozzle, you'll see a little wire mesh in there, and the purpose of that is to stop flashbacks. Gas can burn freely outside of the nozzle, but it doesn't work its way back inside because that wire mesh stops it. Now what's really interesting is if we remove the sheathing from the nozzle here, the flame actually goes out. And if we try and relight that again, it won't actually work. The hole in the tip here is so small, it's shooting the gas out like a jet. And so we're not able to light it, even with a barbecue igniter. It whisks the heat away so quickly, there's no time for ignition. So let's make the hole bigger. So here's the basic idea. I got myself a hacksaw and a drill with a 9/32-inch drill bit. We're gonna use the hacksaw to cut the tip off the torch and the drill bit to hollow it out. And there we have it. As easy as that, we've got an instant homemade propane spewer. The hole on this nozzle is exponentially wider than the factory version, and so when we open the valve now, there's nothing to restrict the flow. So the nozzle cools down quickly and begins dripping liquid propane. Now I'm gonna try something now that you probably shouldn't try at home. I'm gonna open this valve all the way and touch it off with a barbecue igniter. Just wanna see what happens. Is anything gonna happen? There we go. Oh, sweet. Now you might be wondering why the flame didn't travel back into the bottle and make this thing explode, and here's why. We know that the fire triangle says three things need to be present in order for combustion to happen. We need to have an ignition source, we need to have fuel, and we need to have oxygen. But there's no oxygen in the bottle, so there's no way for combustion to take place until it travels out of the nozzle and mixes with the oxygen in the air. But saying that, this still isn't an experiment I can recommend for anyone else. All right, now for the fun part. The backyard scientist found that if we crank this valve fully open and turn it upside down and leave it in a glass, all we have to do is give it a few minutes and the glass will fill itself up. So we have our propane with our modified tip, we have a glass, so let's go ahead and put the two together and see if it really works. It is. So now that we've got our glass filling up with propane, let me tell you about some of the characteristics of propane itself. We already know that propane is normally a gas, but if you compress it and stick it in a pressurized steel container, it'll actually carry as a liquid. The liquid itself is pretty cold, but maybe not as cold as you might think. It's nowhere near the boiling point of liquid nitrogen. Propane boils at minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit, that's about minus 42 degrees Celsius. But the amazing thing is it won't freeze until it hits minus 306. Now even though it's far from being as cold as liquid nitrogen, making contact with your bare skin can cause frostbite. But the bigger concern here is this liquid is flammable, meaning if you got it near a flame or a spark, it could go off and cause a lot of damage. Propane vapors are actually heavier than air, which means they're not gonna float away into the atmosphere. They will sink down into the corners of the room. So if you're working in a very confined space with propane, there's a small chance it could push out all the air and suffocate you. There we go, guys. It's been about 6 or 7 minutes. Our glass is about halfway full, and you can see the stuff is cold because frost is forming on the outside of the glass itself. But our capture rate has decreased quite a bit. I think that's because most of the liquid is out and we're just blowing bubbles at this point. The interesting thing is our tank is still going. It's slowed down, but it's still pumping out liquid propane. Look at this down in here. So let's take it apart and play with the liquid itself. So there we go, guys. The goal of this experiment was to extract liquid propane, and I think you could say we've done that successfully. But there are a couple more quick experiments I want to try before we go. First off, what will a marshmallow do soaked in liquid propane, and what will happen if we light it off? Okay, here we go, dunk number one. Oh, you hear that? It's already frozen solid. That's cool. Look how hard that is. That's cool. That froze pretty quick. Let's leave it in there for about another minute. Yeah, that's about a minute. Let's take it out and smash it. Oh, that's hard. Nice. Yeah, it's like really crispy on the outside, but still a little bit of gooey on the inside. Maybe I should have left that in a bit longer because now I just made a mess everywhere. Let's try that again. But this time I'm gonna light it off. All right, that's been about a minute. You can see this thing is actually so crispy, it chips off. So I'm gonna light it up away from the propane. Nope, that burned up pretty quickly. It didn't even scorch the whole thing. So marshmallows and liquid propane, kind of cool, but there's one bigger question on my mind that I'd really like to see the results to. What would happen if we touched an open flame to a glass of liquid propane? Would the whole thing explode? Would it go up in a big fireball? Or would it just sit there and casually burn? You and I both know there's only one way to find out. Now, I'm not exactly sure what's gonna happen, so I came out here to a big cement pad. I think I'm just gonna set this thing down and throw lit matches into it so we can ignite it from a distance. Sounds safe, right? Here we go, moment of truth. Ooh! Oh, that was so close. There we go. Yes. Okay, so that wasn't incredibly dangerous. Looks like is it still burning? It is. So there's a little flame in there, but that's not super dangerous at all. In fact, you can barely even see the flame. If you look closely, you can actually see my match floating at the bottom. What if I roll it around a little bit? Oh, wow, look at that. Got the little bits of marshmallow on the side there burning. Wow. So it didn't explode, and this actually makes sense because if you think about it, this whole container is filled with propane. Like the bottle itself, there's not much oxygen here, so it doesn't actually ignite until it gets up here where it meets the atmosphere. But if I shake it around, I can agitate that and create a lot more gas venting off and get this thing quite a bit bigger. If we were to pour this stuff out on the concrete, it would have a lot more surface area and probably create a much more dramatic effect. I'm actually gonna try it. I'm gonna pour this on the pavement. Here we go. Cool. And it's gone in an instant. It's just gone. It would have sat there and burned for indefinite amounts of time in the glass, but you throw it on the concrete, boom, it's gone. That was very cool. Let's go ahead and summarize what we just learned here today. We know that propane is a gas in its normal state, but when compressed and confined to a container, it turns into a liquid. We found that traditional propane nozzles are designed to mix air with the propane to give a nice teal blue color, but that if we remove the shroud that mixes the air, it won't light off at all. We chopped off the tip of the nozzle with a hacksaw and drilled out the inside and found that rather than exploding, the large amount of gas being expelled burned slowly with the air, causing a bright orange flame. We opened the valve all the way, tipped it upside down in a cup, and left it for about 6 minutes, where we extracted all the liquid propane and got half a glass, or about one cup. We tried freezing marshmallows to see what they would do and found they got really crispy on the outside, but unless they're soaked longer, they stay pretty gummy on the inside. And finally, we tried lighting matches and throwing them into an open container of liquid propane to see what would happen, where we discover all that really happens is it just slowly burns off the top as it's able to mix with the air. So there you have it, guys. Now you know how to modify your propane torches to extract liquid propane. But remember, this stuff is extremely flammable, and this probably isn't an experiment you really want to try at home. But I'm sure glad you joined me for this video, and I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. I guess it comes out the back. Good to know. Like made marshmallow snow. That's gonna be a bugger to clean up.